Hi, this is Shop Talk. I'm Ria Tanuatco-Trillo. Holy Week is just around the corner, but we'd already like to give you some ideas on how you can celebrate Easter Sunday. But we won't talk about the usual Easter egg hunt events today. Instead, we'll show you activities you can do with your kids at home or with the kids attending your Easter party. Arts and crafts is first on our list, and for that, we're joined by Bambi Mañosa Tanhutko. She is the creative director of Creative Kids Studio, and also with us is teacher Robbie Singh, creative facilitator and designer at Creative Kids. Hi, guys. Thanks for coming on the show.
Hi.
All right, Bambs, let's talk about you and your background. You don't just teach art, right?
Yes, actually, my background is interior design. I'm really an interior designer, but I decided to take my master's in art education. So I decided to learn more about what happens when kids learn while they're doing art activities. What is it that they are interested in, and age-appropriate activities for them, rather than just opening a book and copying an activity. I wanted to develop a curriculum that was age-appropriate and that was also fun and that was subliminal learning as well.
Okay, so what happens to kids when they do art then?
When kids do art, you teach them without their knowing, no? They learn to think creatively. They learn to think out of the box. And that's the way we teach in Creative Kids.
Yes.
We don't do the usual
art in regular schools.
Yeah.
We don't teach the kids. Well, we teach the kids to use their imagination more. So, because in kids, it's natural for them to be very imaginative, right? So we start from that imagination, then we build on it. We don't dictate on the kids on what to do.
Yeah, okay. We sort of draw out the creativity of every child.
All right, so you have like the basic activity, the basic process,
yes.
But the rest is up to the child.
Yes.
And there's nothing really right or nothing really wrong.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
we don't. You're hurting another kid.
Right. We don't dictate the color. If they want to paint their apples blue, it's okay. If they want to paint their trees pink and purple,
if they want their
then
zebras
that's fine.
Rainbow, go ahead.
Yeah.
Okay. That's great. And what are the courses that you offer according to that age appropriateness you talked about earlier?
Okay, so from two, we have classes for 2-year-olds and then 3 to 4.
Mm-hmm.
And what do they do?
That's arts and crafts, but we do the discipline-based art ed method, which is teaching them a little bit about history, aesthetics, criticism, and then we do the art production. Art production.
You can do
is
that with the little
doing.
Kids, or this is older kids?
These are kids ages 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 7 to 9. So the 3 to 4s, maybe just a little bit about, you know, something really short,
mm-hmm.
about, say, if we want to talk about Van Gogh,
mm-hmm.
or if we want to talk about Amor Solo.
Yes.
We show them a photo, mm-hmm. and not necessarily going into the detail, but what do you see in this artwork?
Yes, like more of what they observe.
The observation, yeah. So they familiarize themselves with art.
Okay, mm-hmm. So you're not really teaching them, you know, like the detailed this and that techniques of Amor Solo or whoever.
No.
It's just asking them what they see.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Actually,
okay.
It depends on their age. Because like when they're really young, they can only, they understand colors and shapes. But as they grow, as they get older, that's when you start going into details, like who the artist is and what they did and stuff like that.
And then that's how they gradually build on their appreciation.
Right.
So what then would you say is like the mission vision of a Creative Arts Studio? Because as we said, it's more than just teaching kids how to paint.
Yes, mm-hmm. Actually it's a little, we decided to put it in a poem. So I don't know if you'll allow me to read it instead.
Okay, sure.
But,
very
because it's a little difficult to explain. So we say, Creative Kids exist to serve the hope our nation holds, our kids to whom we'll pass the torch as history unfolds. Within each child exists unique abilities and traits. A way to draw these out is what our company creates. Fun, constructive use of talents, a healthy sense of self. These things cannot be taught by any book upon a shelf. We believe that creativity and art can help our kids to grow in body, mind, and spirit, where like countless seeds to sow. A means of self-expression when the soul finds need to speak will serve them in good stead in times when life makes them feel weak. Whether art will be their calling matters not, though this could be. What matters most is that they learn to think creatively. And as each child walks through our doors to join the class of life, we hope to have prepared them both for peaceful times and strife. Okay. So well, that's pretty much what we're all about.
Okay, so teachers like Robbie have to memorize that.
Yes.
I'm just kidding. Okay, all right.
We talk about
that's why
it
we
every
always
day,
have
so.
To read it. Yeah, we always have to read it.
All right, we have our three beautiful girls over there, Natasha, Isabella, and Nuni, who are doing some Easter activities. So while the camera's on them, maybe Teacher Robbie, you can explain exactly what's going on.
Okay, so the first activity, okay, since I see them picking up this piece of, you know,
eggs marks the spot.
Okay, we call the eggs marks the spot.
Okay.
Okay, this one, we actually do a no-waste thing in Creative Kids. So everything that we use, it's all recycled. So the thing that Bella's holding is actually
a used illustration board.
And then we covered it with colored paper. Can be colored cartolina or construction paper. Then after that, what they have to do is use colored markers and just put patterns. Simple patterns, like straight lines, wavy lines, circles.
Whatever, it's up to them.
Yeah, it's up to them.
Okay.
Then after doing that, they could use like our retazos, like our extra colored paper or any other colored paper they have left.
Scraps.
Scraps. They cut it out into circles, okay, or any kind of shapes also.
Okay, which is what Bella's holding there as well, like
Bella's
a more
holding.
Ornate one now.
Okay, so all you have to do is just stick it, okay, and then after that, stick all the sequins, okay, or anything shiny, anything just to spruce it up.
Okay, to give it more bling.
Yes, and then after that, you just attach a stick at the back. Okay, you can use barbecue stick or any stick you find at home.
Okay.
And, you know, that could be useful, but please wash it first.
Yeah.
Okay, and then after gluing it using the hot glue, okay, the glue gun.
You can stick it in the ground?
Yeah, just stick it in the
ground, in the garden.
Oh, okay.
So we call it eggs marks the spot. So you can put it around the garden, like to give kids clues where the eggs are hidden.
Oh, how fun is that?
For Easter. Or it could just be decoration. It could be a centerpiece.
Okay, or you can actually use that as like borders. Like up to where the kids can look for the eggs.
Okay.
You know, like especially when the venue's really big.
Right. Okay. Nakaka-pressure yan sa mga mommy, ha?
Yes.
I don't have anything planned for Easter Sunday.
That's so simple to do. It's really easy.
Great. Okay. All right.
And then, yeah, this is another one.
Okay.
Yeah,
then the other one.
We got eggs on there. They're decorating eggs as well. Am I right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Okay. What Tasha's holding now is, it's a colored hard-boiled egg.
Okay.
We colored it using food coloring and a little bit of vinegar. Vinegar helps keep the color there.
Okay.
Makes it more matingkad.
Okay.
And then using other scrap material again, like for the ears, we used collage paper or any other colored paper. Mm-hmm. They cut it out into ears. Then they could use white glue. You can buy white glue, or you can use hot glue and then stick it on the eggs.
Okay, how do you make the nose though?
The nose. Good
it's
question.
Pom-pom.
Actually, pom poms. Okay. These are actually like scrap Japanese paper.
Okay.
We crumple them, and then wrap them, then just glue it together to make those pom-poms.
Oh, who knew, right? Yeah. We have like a little Indian something mask creature over there, right?
See,
it doesn't
let
need
your
any.
Imagination do the thing.
Exactly. So you don't blow the eggs, like, you know, some people, they like put holes on the top and bottom and they blow out the yolk and the white and then they paint it. You guys just hard boil?
No, it's just
hard
boiled. Yeah.
Okay. And we need the weight also of the egg.
So they don't,
because if it's too light, then you know how kids are, like sometimes when they get too giggle, they kind of crush it.
Right.
So you need the egg inside.
Right. And then you can use the toilet paper rolls, the middle part, the cardboard.
Right.
Yes.
And then, cover them with
paper. Yes, because it rolls, so it's easier for them to put it there. Or like this one here, we cut it up.
Oh,
we
okay.
cut this up.
Then it has like legs.
Then it has like legs. Can
and
you
that's
use that? So it's fun to do this with kids.
Yeah.
So it can be a family activity, actually, even with a chick.
Yes, actually, most of these eggs here
were done by
Bella and Tasha.
Wow. Yeah. Where do you get like all the, like the, what do you call that thing?
The pipe cleaner.
There you go.
Yeah,
thank
the pipe
you.
The pipe cleaners. These are the pipe cleaners.
Yeah,
we have the fuzzy wires.
We sell it ourselves.
Ah, okay. All right.
Yeah,
we sell it ourselves.
We
have a supplier for that, and then we sell it ourselves.
Okay. Then you also have like feathers and
yes.
yarn and
right.
glitter.
Yeah. This one's the angel.
The angel.
Oh, that is too cute.
And we have the Rapunzel here.
That's Rapunzel.
Oh, that's Rapunzel.
Yes.
Okay,
this
very
is Rapunzel.
Tangled.
Let down your hair.
Inspired, right?
Yes, inspired
and
by
we have the DJ. Over here.
Okay, who's like full of glitter.
Yes.
Right? So these eggs, you can use them. They could be part of the hunt, or they could be a centerpiece. Or
yes, or they could be just a fun activity to do Easter time with your kids.
So this is good for starting what age?
two, actually,
yeah,
because
they can dip and dye
the eggs.
Okay.
Or they can help you put the feathers. They can help you choose, and then you assemble it.
For them.
Okay, so they'll just tell you like what material they want on there.
Yes.
And what coloring are you use? That's food coloring.
Food coloring.
Just the regular food color in the grocery, and then like Robbie said, you mix it with a bit of
vinegar
and water.
All right.
That's it.
Okay. Fabulous.
Then if ever they need like. Like I know like some materials here, like the beads or the pipe cleaners, they don't know where to get it. They can also get it from us because we also supply art kits.
That's right.
To kids
yes.
also.
Okay,
for
and
them
can we see
do.
What the three girls have done over there? I think the girls were really busy while we were here talking, right? Okay, or are the eggs here the ones that they did? Or these are all the ones that they
did? Yes, they did all this. Maybe they want to come and just
show they have some here, and then they have two over there.
Two over there. Okay, but Bambi, you need to tell us first. You normally do these classes out of your house, but that's going to change soon.
Yes, it's going to change. We're finally moving to the Alabang Town Center. We're going to be in the Commerce Mall, in the Commerce Strip area, and we'll be opening, hopefully,
by May.
By May.
All right, so all the same fun activities, but you can have
and
now
more,
in the mall.
Yes. And as well as birthday parties as well.
We do
arts and crafts parties for kids.
Okay, all your numbers are there on the screen. Yeah. Robbie and Bambi, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
All right. Next, Chef Carol from CCA will show us how to make Easter cookies. That's happening after this break. Keep it here. Shop Talk will be right back. Great. Stay seated.